Dear friends, see last time we saw what is path length, what is displacement. Okay, we also saw about what is speed and what is velocity. Now, I'll give you one example for the practice. Let us say an object moves on path ABC. This is 5 meter, 12 meter. Okay, now see our direction also mentioned. East, west, north and south. Now see the object moves on the path ABC. Okay. What we have to find out? Speed and velocity. Now to find the speed and velocity, we require distance and that is path length and displacement. Now first we find out the path length or a distance, that is AB plus BC. Okay. Now see the time to move from A to C, let us say given is 5 seconds. Now we have obtained the path length, now the displacement. Now as I discussed earlier, as we have discussed earlier, see the displacement is the shortest distance between two points. So A is our initial point, position xi, this is our final position. Xf is the final position. AC is a displacement, there is a AC. Now this is a right angle triangle AB square plus. Now you studied about this Pythagoras triplets 30 minutes. Okay, now we have to find out the speed. Speed is distance upon time. Velocity is displacement upon time. Distance here is how much? 30. Okay. Sorry, 5 plus 12 is 17 meter. 17 upon 5. Okay. AB plus BC is 5 plus 12 will be 17. Displacement we have obtained is this. Now 17 by 5 is 13 by 4. 13 by 10, 3.4 meter per second. And okay, so this is how we can find out speed and velocity. Okay, now we take another example in which we will understand distance, displacement, speed and velocity. Now as I mentioned, whenever we have one dimension, we consider x-axis. Now let us say an object starts from A. Moves to B. And finally reach to C. Okay? So you move on ABC path. Okay. Now let us say time to move from A to B is 6 seconds and B to C is 4 seconds. Okay. Now see what we have to calculate. First we have to calculate distance, then displacement and then speed and velocity. Now see the distance or a path length is AB plus BC. See this, it has started from A to B, then A to C. Now what is distance AB? See distance formula we discussed, A minus B. What is the number corresponds to A? Is 40. Number corresponds to B is this, 70. Now See the origin to the left to the origin, 0 is the origin, left is considered negative. C corresponds to minus 20. Okay? Minus 30. Okay? Now, as we discussed, distance is always positive. 120. Okay? Now, displacement. Okay. Now, as I told, displacement can be positive, zero, or negative. Okay. Now, displacement is xf minus xi. See, what is the final position? See, A is our initial position, xi. C is the final position, xf. What is the number correspond to C? That is minus 20. And what is number correspond to A? That is 40. Okay. What do the negative sign shows here? See, the negative sign shows that it has moved left to the initial point. It has moved to left to the initial point. Now we have obtained distance and displacement. Okay. Now we have obtained distance and displacement. See, the total time A to B is 6 seconds, B to C is 4 seconds. So total time okay. So now once we obtain path length or distance and displacement, we can easily calculate the speed and the velocity. Now speed is distance upon time. Now distance we have calculated is 120 meter, time is 10 seconds. Okay, now velocity is displacement upon time. Now displacement is minus 60. Okay, time is 10 seconds. Okay, now see the velocity we obtain is a negative value. Speed is scalar quantity. Okay. More regarding scalar and vector quantity we will study in the higher standard. Okay. Speed is always positive. See here we get the positive value 12 meter per second. But the velocity can be positive, zero, or negative. That is an important characteristic of the velocity. So here velocity we obtain as a minus 6 meter per second. So this is about how we can obtain speed and velocity. Okay, now we have taken a number of example in which we have obtained path length, that is distance. See, we have taken obtained displacement, then how to calculate speed and velocity. Now we proceed further. Okay, we can have a number of examples. See, that is I will give you in the practice. Now see, speed is distance upon time. Next, we have to study average speed. Is total distance upon total time. Okay? Speed is distance upon time, whereas average speed is a total distance upon total time. Now, we take a simple example. Suppose a 100 meter race, see an athlete moves from A to B. See, first 60 meter, okay, it covers in 7 seconds, okay, and the remaining 40 meter, it covers in 3 seconds, okay, what will be the average speed? Now here, total distance is 60 plus 40. And total time okay. Now average speed, see the symbol for average speed वी बार और ए सी दिस वी कॉल एज वी बार दैट इज अ सिंबल ऑफ एवरेज स्पीड. सी व्हेन वी रिप्रेजेंट इन फॉर्म ऑफ अ ब्रैकेट देन ऑल्सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंट द एवरेज स्पीड. सो दिस इज अ सिंबल ऑफ एवरेज स्पीड. ओके नाउ सी हियर एवरेज स्पीड इज टोटल डिस्टेंस अपॉन टोटल टाइम. टोटल डिस्टेंस इज 100, टोटल टाइम इज 10 मीटर पर सेकंड. ओके सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन ऑब्टेन द एवरेज स्पीड. नाउ सी राइट नाउ इट इज गिवन सम न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू. नाउ व्हाट हैपन इफ इट इज गिवन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द पार्ट्स. नाउ वी स्टार्ट विद अ सिंपल एग्जांपल. नाउ सी फर्स्ट दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सी द आउटकम विल बी कैन बी यूज एज अ फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो. नाउ लेट अस से एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूव्स फ्रॉम ए टू बी. ए नाउ सी द हाफ ऑफ द डिस्टेंस इट मूव्स विद द स्पीड वी वन एंड रिमेनिंग हाफ डिस्टेंस इट मूव्स विद द स्पीड वी टू. What will be the average speed? So here, what we say that in both part, distance same. Okay. Now see the question says the half of the distance covered, it moves with the speed v1, and remaining half distance with the speed v2. What you have to calculate average speed. Now what is the formula of the average speed? Total distance upon total time. Now see the total distance but what we see from the data ki nowhere time is given. Nowhere time is given. So first you have to find out time. So let us say in the first part here time is t1 and in the second part time is t. Okay, now we use the formula speed is equal to distance upon time. Speed distance is d by 2, time is t1. So t1 is d upon 2v1. This will move to the denominator. Similarly, second part distance is d by 2 and speed is v2. D by 2 and time is t2. So t2 is d upon 2v2. Now what is total time? Let us say t. Total time will be sum of this t1 plus t. See how we have obtained this. Speed is distance upon time, that is v1 is d by 2 upon let us say time is t1. So t1 will be d upon 2v1. V2 will be d by 2 upon t2. These two will move to the denominator and we interchange the position. So the total time is d upon 2v1 plus. See what we can take common. D by 2 common. 1 upon v1 plus 1 upon v2. Okay. Now we try to simplify. V1 plus v2 upon. Okay. Okay. Now this is a total time. Now average speed is total distance. What is total distance here is d. And what is total time? That we have obtained d v1 plus v2. Okay. Now, if I simplify, this will move to the numerator. Okay. So, when we are given a data in a such a way, in the distance in the both part is same, speed is different, then average speed v bar is 2v1 v2 upon. See, sometimes they arrange like this. Sometimes they arrange like this, that also true. Suppose if I take reciprocal of this, 1 upon v bar is v1 plus v2 upon 2v1 v2. 2 I am taking on the left hand side, v1 plus v2 upon. Now v1 upon v1 v2 plus. Okay, 1 upon V2 plus okay. Sometimes you may see in this format, okay, but basic formula will be this. See, in the both part distance is same, then average speed is 2 V1 V2 upon V1 plus V2. See, this can be extended to more number of parts also, but right now it is not in our scope, so that's why we do not discuss. So this was the first case where in the both part distance is same. Now see, we discuss the second case where time is same in both part. Okay, time is same in both part. Let us say the object moves from A to B. See, for time t it travels with the speed v1, and for the similar time it moves with the speed v2. See, earlier part what we saw, the distance was same in the both part, but you can see here time is same but speed is different. Now what is the formula of the average speed we have talked? It is total distance upon total time. But what we see from the data, nowhere distance is given. So what we have to do? First obtain the distance. Now see, total time we are already having, but distance is not there. We use the formula speed is equal to distance upon time. See, the first part, let us say distance is d1, and the second part distance is d2. Okay, now speed v1 is d1 upon t. By the same reasoning, okay, now what is the total distance? Now what we have done, d we have obtained in terms of v and t, that is b, t is common. Okay, now we have obtained total distance. Now total time we are already having, total distance we have obtained. Average speed is total distance upon total time. Total distance we have, total time is this. Okay, so this is how we can prove that when time interval is same in both parts, average speed is v1 plus v2 by. Okay, these are important derivation. Okay, will be useful to in solving the example. This we can remember as a formula also. Okay, so once we remember in terms of the formula, we can easily calculate this one. See, I take a simple example based on these two formula. Okay, see, a car covers 1st half of distance covered with speed of 30 km/h and remaining half with speed of 80 km/h. Okay, calculate okay. See, a car covers 1st half of the distance covered with a speed of 30 km/h and the remaining half with a speed of 80 km/h. calculate the average speed. Now see the first half, that is d/2, and remaining half, okay, distance d/2. So which is the case here? Just now we have obtained that average speed is, see, 2 v1 v2 upon v1 plus v2. Here there is d/2 d/2. So what is the formula? Average speed is, okay, now what is v1 is 30, okay, okay. Okay. Kilometer per hour. So here also the case where distance in the both half is same, so we can use the formula 2 v1 v2 upon v1 plus v2. Now let us say we take another example. A car travel first 30 minutes, speed of 50 km/h, and see a car travels first 30 minute with the speed of 50 km/h, and remaining and next 30 minutes with speed of 70 km/h. Calculate here. See, a car travel first 30 minutes with a speed of 50 km/h and next 30 minutes with the speed of 70 km/h. See what you have to calculate average speed. Now see here, first 30 minutes and the next 30 minutes. See what we see here, the time interval is same. Okay, so now we have seen the formula. When time interval is same, average speed is v1 plus v2 by 2. Okay, so here v1 is how much? 50. V2 is 70. So 50 plus. Okay. Okay. So this is how we can solve. See, in the both part time is same, so we can use the formula average speed is v1 plus v2 by. Okay, now this is the formula for the average speed when time interval is same in both part. See, sometimes you may have a combination of this. Okay, sometimes you may have a combination of this, then we should be able to solve. So this is about the average speed and see the average velocity. Okay. Now see, so far we have talked of distance, displacement, speed and velocity. Now see, next we have to see about acceleration. Okay. Now see the time rate of change of velocity is called see the time rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. See, all of you are knowing that our vehicles are provided accelerator, that you are fond of. Okay, So what is the function of the accelerator? To increase the velocity. And our vehicle also have a braking system, brake system, that is used to decelerate. Okay, that is negative acceleration. See, acceleration is positive, deacceleration or a retardation, okay, have a negative value. See, acceleration also can be positive, zero or negative. Okay, so now next we have to see the acceleration. Let us say time t is equal to z, velocity is u. Okay, that we call as initial velocity. Sometimes it is used as v0 also. At time t, the velocity is v, that is final velocity. See, by definition, acceleration is change in velocity upon time interval. Okay, acceleration is change in velocity upon time interval. Now here at t is equal to 0, initial velocity is u or v0. At time t, different book it is used differently, so we can, it can be u0 or v, one and the same. At time t, the final velocity. Acceleration is a, symbol is a, is change in velocity. What is change in velocity here? V minus u upon time is t minus. Okay, so a is equal to v minus u upon t. A t is v minus u. Okay, so this is how we obtain the relation between initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration and time. Okay, now what is the unit of acceleration? See, change in velocity, that will be meter per second, and time interval is in second, meter per second square. See, sometimes you write ms minus 2 also. Okay, so acceleration unit is meter per second square. Now see, what is acceleration? See, the time rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Let us say at t is equal to 0, see, that is moment we start observing motion. Initial velocity is u. See, at time t is equal to t, the final velocity. Acceleration is change in velocity upon time interval. Now we substitute the value, a is equal to v minus u, that is v minus u upon t minus 0. A is equal to v minus u upon t. A t is v minus u, v is equal to u plus a t. Sometimes you write, okay, now see, when velocity increases with time, it is positive acceleration. Okay, velocity increases with the time, then it is positive acceleration. When velocity decrease with time, gives for negative value, see, this is called retardation or okay, both have the same meaning. Now see, our vehicles are provided with a braking system. Okay, suppose we are moving in a vehicle, and when our destination is reached, we apply brake, so there is a decrease in the velocity and finally the vehicle stops. Such motion is called retarded motion or deacceleration. Now see, the object moves with a constant velocity. Okay, Yeah? When the object moves with a constant velocity, acceleration is 0. So in that case, what happened? See, initial velocity and final velocity will be same. Now if I substitute, because V is equal to U, okay? Now in such case, the object moves with a constant velocity, okay? Object moves with a constant velocity. So this is about the acceleration. See, what is acceleration? See, the time rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Formula of acceleration is A is equal to V minus U upon T. See, when the velocity increases with the time, we have got positive value of acceleration. When the velocity decreases with the time, we have got negative value of the acceleration. See, when object moves with a constant velocity, acceleration is zero. Okay? So, we have to remember this formula. A is equal to V minus U upon T. Now, all this motion we discuss can be represented graphically also. Okay, so today we start with the first time of graph, that is x versus t graph. Okay, x versus t graph. See, x is a distance or a displacement. Time. Okay. Now see the first type of graph. See, when position of the object do not changes with time, over the time interval the object is stationary. Okay. Now see, suppose when you are sitting in a class, see the time has changed, but position do not change. See, that is a object is stationary. First graph. Okay. Or object is at rest. Second graph. Okay. X versus T graph. Now, here we draw x versus t graph for a given object. Okay. Now, here what we see, x versus t graph is a straight line. Okay. Now, see, first time interval is 2 seconds. Distance covered is 6 minus 0 is 6 meter. Okay? 0 to 2 second. Time interval 2 second. Distance is 6 minus 0 is 6. Now next time interval 4 minus 2. Distance covered is 12 minus 6. Next time interval is 6 minus 4. And distance is 18 minus 12. See, in every 2 second time interval, the object covers 6 meter. So, when x versus t graph is a straight line, okay, object moves with a constant speed, that is uniform motion. So, if object cover equal distance in equal time interval, then it perform okay. See, the object cover equal distance in equal time interval, then we can say it perform uniform motion. See, what we have seen here, time interval is same, distance covered during each time interval is also same. So in that case we say it moves with a constant speed or velocity. Okay. Now see very interesting thing about such type of graph. Okay. So x versus t graph. First the object is at rest. See what we have seen here, the position time interval changes. So the time changes but position does not change. So if x versus t graph is parallel to time axis, object is at a rest or stationary. Okay, if x versus t graph is parallel to the time axis, you studied about the parallel lines in the earlier standards. Okay, now let us say this is one line and this is second line, parallel to time axis, object is stationary. Now if object cover equal distance in equal time interval, then it performs uniform circular motion. Okay, here in uniform motion, object covers equal distance in equal time interval. We say it moves with a constant speed or velocity. See, if x is a distance, then we'll get speed. If x is a velocity, then we'll get velocity. Okay, so see the more regarding the graph, we'll take in the next lecture. Thank you.